Well, Euclid had the straight edge and the compass. That those were the tools that he had available. He didn't have a very good paper. A completely different approach that you can take to constructions, which is, well, it's much less classical, and so it's less talked about, is to use folding paper instead of a straight edge and a compass. Now, if you think about it, folding paper uses nothing. First of all, you can't ever do circles. You'll never be able to fold a circle onto a paper. So all you have ever is straight lines. If you think about, is this stronger or weaker than this set of tools that Euclid was using, the intuitive answer is that it must be weaker. But sometimes the intuitive answer is not the right answer. Let me just jump right in and show you how to trisect an angle by folding paper. What I'd like you to realize is that essentially you have a straight edge. Because if you have two points that you previously constructed somehow, then you can fold the paper so that those two points are on the crease. This is exactly the same thing as connecting them by a straight edge. Even better, you can do perpendicular bisector in a single step, because you can fold the paper so that these two points cover each other. And when you do that, the created crease will be perpendicular to the line segment connecting those points, and it will cut it exactly in half because they covered each other. So to trisect an angle, first we have to create an angle. A right angle is not very interesting. You can trisect a right angle with straight edge and compass, which is probably an important point to make. It's not that there's no angle whatsoever that you can trisect. It's that you can trisect an arbitrary angle. So 90 degrees you can trisect because you can construct a 30-degree angle. So we want to create an arbitrary angle so that our job is not so easy. So I'll just fold the paper so that the bottom of this crease is right at the corner. So this is the angle. We created it arbitrarily. We don't know how big it is. So I'll try to draw a line just inside the crease.
Okay. You're going to trisect that.
I'm going to trisect that. So first we fold the paper in half. So I just fold the bottom up to the top so that they match exactly. Then I fold the bottom up to the half. So now I have this crease at the halfway. So now I have these two creases, one up here and one down here. Now, here's the trick. I'll mark two points. One is this bottom of the angle, the tip. And the second one is this point on the edge of the paper that's halfway up. I will fold the paper so that this point at the tip of the angle lines up, matches this line, this crease that I created before. And this point halfway up the paper matches this line, which is the angle itself. So I'm going to fold it and fiddle it around. Okay, now once I found that alignment, I'm going to put my hand down and crease the line. And then I take a pen and mark this point where the tip got. Okay, open it up. And another important point to mark is where this crease that that I just created with this last fold, where that intersects the bottom line. So you might already see where this is going.
Yeah.
I will fold to connect the tip of the angle with this marked point, and then fold again to connect the tip of the angle with the other marked point. Yep. And magic.
That's it, is it?
The angle. That's it. So since we are folding, we can check that, not prove it, but check it by folding the crease and see that it matches up and then folding this crease in. And see that it matches up, so the three. So if you want to prove that, that's it's an exercise. It's doable if you remember your congruent triangles.
What power does origami have that the straight edge and compass didn't have?
Exactly. Very good question. So the trick was this one step that I did, which was taking these 2 points and lining them up with 2 lines. So if you allow that step, which is a reasonable step, I mean, if I have a paper, it's very easy to do. So the key is that if you translate this step to what it does to coordinates, the same way that I told you about in the context of straight edge and compass, what it does is this crease that it creates is a shared tangent of two parabolas. And to solve that equation, to find a shared tangent of two parabolas, you need to do something cubic.
That was the one thing that was beyond Euclid.
That was the one thing that's beyond Euclid. And it turns out that with origami, phrased in terms of what are the constructible numbers, what are all the coordinates that we can construct, we can do addition, subtraction, multiplication, fractions, square roots, and cube roots.
So origami is more powerful than Euclidean geometry.
It's more powerful than Euclidean geometry. Even better, if I give you any cubic equation, you can construct by origami the solution. So you could solve a cubic equation, which is the formula is really, really big and ugly and hard to plug into. You can solve it just by a simple folding mechanism and then measuring the solution. So I showed you how to do square root 2. I showed you how to do 3. I showed you how to do 1/3. It turns out that you can do all numbers that just involve fractions and square roots, and addition and subtraction. But there's a problem with cube roots. So what this guy proved is that you will never be able to do cube roots